Hi, I'm Mike Tourville from Evans Cooling Systems. I'm here at West Coast Marketing in Upland, California, and we're going to convert this 2007 JK Jeep to Evans Waterless Coolant. When Jeeps like this are operating in extreme environments, you're subjected to hot, dusty, dirty conditions. That often leads to overheating. With water-based coolants, you're subjected to corrosion, electrolysis, and boilover, which means overheating. With Evans waterless coolants, those problems go away because Evans stops corrosion, it stops electrolysis, and most important, Evans' high boiling point of 375 degrees means you won't form vapor, you won't build pressure, and it stays in its liquid state. Here's what we'll need to get the job done right. We'll need the Evans high performance waterless coolant. We'll also need the Evans prep fluid to flush the system out thoroughly. Now we're going to use a blower here in this shop, but you can also use a leaf blower or a Shop-Vac. The important thing is to have it high volume air rather than high pressure air. And this blower, Shop-Vac or leaf blower will do the job right. Now once we're done blowing all the air out, blowing all the old coolant out of the system, and we're through with the conversion, we want to test the water content. That's very important. Now there's a couple different means to do that. One is with a refractometer, in which you would just put coolant on, put it on the glass, look at the scale, and match the corresponding chart to know that you've got less than 3% water. When you're through with the job, it's important to put the Do Not Add Water stickers on top of the radiator to avoid adding water by mistake or somebody not realizing this is a waterless system and you want it to stay waterless. We're removing the radiator cap, but before we do that, we make sure the engine's cooled down, because with water-based coolants, they'll form vapor, they'll build pressure, and you never want to open up a hot radiator. And when we get underneath, we're going to open up the lower radiator hose, open up the block drain, and let the coolant flow out. Now that we've drained out all the old water-based coolant, we've reconnected all the hoses, block drain, lower radiator hose, and we're going to pour in prep fluid. We're going to start the engine and run it with the heat on high for about 10 or 15 minutes. This will make sure that we've run enough prep fluid through the heater circuit to get it through the entire cooling system. We've run prep fluid through the entire cooling system. We drained and blew it out completely. Now it's time to add in the Evans high performance coolant. We're going to run the engine with the heat on high for about 10 or 15 minutes. That'll ensure that the coolant is run through the entire heating circuit. We're going to use an analog refractometer to measure the water content by placing a small sample of the coolant on the glass of the refractometer. We'll just hold it up to the light and measure the reading. And we say we're at 56 on the brick scale, which means we're just below 2%. That's good, because we want to be below 3% for a successful conversion. We've tested the water content. It's close to 0%. We've put the Do Not Add Water sticker on, so that means we've completed a conversion to Evans High Performance Waterless Coolant.